Welcome to this video. I hope you installed Simomatic and downloaded the server and gateway and installed that as well. Now we will begin with our first exercise. Now this exercise is about motor control circuit, in which we will design a circuit to control the direction of the motor. Now in this circuit, we need a diagram. So either you can create your own diagram or you can use a diagram which I've created for you. This is provided in the resource section or in the description of the video. So using this diagram, we are going to build the system in Simomatic, and it's very easy and very intuitive. So let's start with a diagram first. So this is my diagram in which we have a power circuit and a control circuit. So the power circuit is providing three-phase supply to the motor. So if you see in the beginning, we have a three-phase supply giving L1, L2, L3. It's going to a circuit breaker, because circuit breaker is used for protection. If the ampere of the whole circuit is more than the circuit breaker rating or circuit breaker critical current settings, it will trip. It's for the safety. So the input of circuit breaker is the output of three-phase supply, and the output of circuit breaker is going to a contactor. In this case, we are using a reversible contactor, which can change the polarity of the supply within itself. So you see in this contactor, we have two coils. Here, this coil and this one. So this coil and this coil has its own contacts inside. So there are six contacts. So let's see what happens when this coil gets energized. In this case, L1 in is going to L1 out, and L2 in is going to L2 out, and L3 in is going to L3 out. And this is going to the motor, L1, L2, and L3. So motor is getting L1, L2, L3 in a sequence. Now, what happens if this coil gets energized? We have these three contacts. So in this case, L1 out will get L1 in, same sequence. L2 out now will get L3 in. So the sequence is interchanged. And L3 out will get L2 in. Okay, so we have these two coils and two indicators next to that. So how do we energize these coils? This is done by two push buttons. So if you see here, control circuit, we have 24 volt and 0 volt, which is connected to this symbol, and that's my emergency stop. So emergency stop is breaking 24 and 0 if it is pressed. And then you have 24 signals coming to input of two push buttons. So input of buttons are connected to 24 volts, and the output of buttons are connected to individual coils. So this S01 is connected to this coil, and S02 is connected to another coil. All right, very simple. So by energizing these push buttons, we change the direction. And if you want to know what these symbols which I've used there, you can read that here. All right, so this diagram you will find in the description. You can download that for your reference. Now let's come back to Simomatic. I have already built the system in Simomatic. If you don't have the system, one thing is you can use my system. It is available in the public systems. Another thing is you can build yourself. If you build yourself, you will learn even more. Okay, so let's see how we have connected these components together with respect to our drawing. So I will open that again. Main supply, L1, L2, L3 is going to input of circuit breaker. So what is the main supply here? You can see I have linked these symbols. This symbol is main supply and CB01 to the symbols here. So main supply is here, and here the main supply is this one, this big connector. So this is giving three-phase supply to my whole system. So if I click this one, you will see here L1, L2, L3, and it has a maximum current capacity of 100 amperes. Right now it's not overload, it's false. So if you see this input, the output of this L1, L2, L3 is connected to CB01 L1N, CB01 L2N, and CB01 L3N. So just like in the diagram, these inputs are connected to power supply. So this you can connect here. So if I show you this connection, you can see if there is any voltage or current or not. If I play this, you can see the voltage is coming to the circuit breaker input. And this voltage is coming because the circuit breaker is activated. If I turn it off, then this input is still getting the voltage, but output is not giving the voltage. So by turning it off, this L1 out, L2 out, and L3 out is zero, okay? So this voltage is coming from main supply. And now we will see what is next. Next is the output of the circuit breaker is going to the input of your contactor. So we will just open the contactor now, KM01, and here the contactor is this one, this device, this black device. So this was the circuit breaker, this is the contactor, and in contactor, if you see the input, it's the output of circuit breaker. So you will see CB01 out, CB01 L2 out, CB01 L3 out. Now here I can show you. So this is now getting 230 volts each line because the circuit breaker is, it's closed. If I open this one, you will see the voltage is gone. So the input of contactor is getting supply from here. Okay, very nice. Now the output of this contactor is connected to my motor, which is L1, L2, and L3. So L1 out, L2 out, and L3 out. This we can see in the motor. So I go to the motor now. It's M01. So you can see the input of motor is KM01, L1 out. KM01 is the contactor. L2, L3. So this motor is getting the signal from contactor. Okay. And last component in this panel is the power supply, which is giving supply to my emergency stop. So if I show you power supply here, you can see negative and positive is connected to EM0111. So you can see here EM0111 and EM0131 to the negative. EM0131. So this is now my control circuit. So I will open the EM01. And here you can see that 11 is positive, 31 is negative, as shown in the diagram. And now the output of emergency stop is going to this push buttons, X1, X1 for S01 and S02. We can relate that S01 is getting from emergency stop 12 number, just like in the diagram, and also S02 X1, 12 number. Very nice. Now we go back to this diagram and we will see the output of my switches. It's going to the coil and it's going also to an indicator. So each switch has, it's connected to two outputs, 21 and X1. This I can show you here. So S01 output, these connections are KM01 and L01. So KM01 X11, L01 X1. Similarly, S02, KM01 21, L02 X1, just like in the diagram. 21 and L01 X1. Okay, so, sorry, it's L02 X1, so because S02 is, just need to interchange that one here, this one will come here. Okay, so this was the circuit diagram, and in the end, the motor is connected to a fan. So here, let's imagine it's a blower or a fan. This is connected to the motor, how it is done that. So if you see in the motor, we have three connections, L1 and L2, L3, and axis. So what we want to move with this motor. So this is connected to my fan, F01. And here you can see that this is connected to the motor axis. All right. Okay, now let's simulate the circuit. Now we have designed the circuit. Now let's go and simulate that one and see the parameters. So all you have to do is once you build that, made the connections, then you have to go to play. And now what will happen? Let's go inside and see this circuit breaker is closed. So let's open it up and see if something happens. So if I press this start button now, wait a second, nothing happened, just an LED is on because this is 24 volt and 0 volt, but the motor is not running because three-phase supply, it's not provided. So I turn it on now. Now it's coming to the contactor. And now if I press this one, you will see motor is running in one direction. And if I press the another one, it is running in another direction. This is with the help of this reversible contactor. And if I press this e-stop, now because my circuit is open here and it's not going to give supply to my coils, this will not run. So 24 volt is canceled and the contactor is also not energized. Okay, so this is how you can also troubleshoot the system. If one of your e-stop is pressed or if your circuit breaker is open, is your system running or not? This is a good way to test the system. All right, so this was a very basic exercise in which we learned about circuit breaker and direction control of AC motor. In the next exercise, we will see how we can use the same motor and control the direction of a conveyor. And in this case, we have a box. And the box will be moving forward and backward with the help of sensors. And we'll also be using an open PLC from CodeAssist. So we'll be programming this CodeAssist platform to control the operation in Simomatic. This is going to be very interesting. So let's see that in the next video. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.